ಋಷಿಭ್ಯೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯ ಕರ್ತೃಭ್ಯೋ ವಂಶ ಋಷಭ್ಯೋ ಮಹದ್ಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ಗುರುಭ್ಯಃ ಸರ್ವೋಪಪ್ಲವರಹಿತ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಘನ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಗರ್ಥೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಸೋಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಓಂ ಪ್ರಪನ್ನ ಪಾರಿಜಾತಾಯ ತೋತ್ರ ವೇತ್ರೈಕಪಾಣಯೇ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಮುದ್ರಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ಗೀತಾಮೃತ ದುಹೇ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶಾಯ. ಮೈ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಶಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪರಿಪೂರ್ಣ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದಂ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ವ್ಯೂವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್ವರ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಚಾನಲ್. ಮೇ ದ ಆಲ್ ಮೈಟಿ ಶ್ರೀ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್ವರ ಬಿಸ್ಟೋ ಆಲ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಸ್ಪರಿಟಿ, ವೆಲ್ತ್, ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಟರ್ನಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್ ಟು ಯು ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟು. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತಾ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ನಂಬರ್ 4 ವರ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 11. ಶ್ರೀ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಉವಾಚ ಯೇ ಯಥಾ ಮಾಂ ಪ್ರಪದ್ಯಂತೆ ತಾನ್ ತಥೈವ ಭಜಾಮ್ಯಹಂ ಮಮ ವರ್ತ್ಮಾನು ವರ್ತಂತೆ ಮನುಷ್ಯಾ ಪಾರ್ಥ ಸರ್ವಶಃ. ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸೆಡ್, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ರೀಚ್ ಮೀ. But many more worship methods are available in our Sanatana Dharma. Worship means, we call it Saguna Brahma Upasana. Upasana means puja, worship. We also worship different deities. So many varieties of deities are available. The other religion people also, sometimes they are not able to understand the method. Even our people, they are not able to understand why so many gods that we do have. We should have only one God. This one group of people say that we should worship only one God. If we have only one God, no confusion will be there. Everybody will take that God. And one more group says that so God should not be given any form, any rupa, any guna. They have to worship like a nirguna upasana. So these categories of people, they don't like to be given a form for Almighty. Almighty must be worshipped as the Almighty without form. This is that group. And one more group of people says, you know, the worship can be according to their wishes. There are so many forms have been given because people wish and they want to have the variety. Therefore, every god which we have their own story, they have their own methodology. We call it even Saparya Paddhati, means every deity is given a particular methodology of the worship. And we also divide Vaidika, Pauranika, Agama, Tantrika. So all so many varieties of pujas available in our Sanatana Dharma. Now in this verse, Bhagavan says, all the varieties of puja, everything leads people to only me. So whatever the way, whatever the method they follow, doesn't matter. Everything is connected to me. That is the beauty. You know, I had lots of students from foreign countries, and the first the question they ask, because we have the temple in our ashram, every day we have to be in the temple for the worship, it's compulsory. So first thing they get in their mind, you know, why so many varieties of God? If you go to Vishnu's temple, so many other deities are there. If you go to Saiva temple and so many deities, not only the main deity, and there are so many praharas and gopurams, varieties of things, and every temple is like a palace, having first round, second round, third round, and the center, we have a sanctum sanctorum called Garbhagraha. So many aspects, so many ideology is involved in our temple. Now in this place, I would like to tell you, every day at least 10 minutes or 15 minutes you have to go into the temple, and you have to give your body to expose. That temple atmosphere should penetrate in your body. So the language which I use, you may feel little bit strange, that rituals, they have their own liveliness. Jaan bolte hain, jaan. So that life will penetrate in you. Every cell which we have in our body, it has got the consciousness. That consciousness will absorb the divinity, the power, the vibrant which exists in the temple. So for that you need not to feel that vibrant vibration. So just to go, expose yourself to that atmosphere. That atmosphere is so divineful because it is involved with the proper methodology which leads to the consciousness, supreme consciousness, and the temple which symbolizes your body alone. So when you go to a temple, there must be a Raja Gopuram. Raja Gopuram means Pradhana Gopuram. That is the symbolization of our face, our sthula sharira. And the next Prahara, small Gopura, and there are so many deities around us. So in our body, there is a system called a subtle body. That subtle body symbolizes that Prahara. Then inner circle, that inner circle is causal body, where the causal body means in our buddhi. In the buddhi, we have the consciousness, that consciousness veiled by our karma phala. That's what called sanctum sanctorum, garbhagraha. So when pujari shows the karpura arati, so just he remembers that consciousness alone. Na tatra suryo bhati na chandra tarakam, nema vidyuto bhanti kuto yam agnihi, tameva bhantam anubhati sarvam, tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati. Then so many varieties, you know. We also worship as Mahavishnu. That Mahavishnu also is given a different mantra. Every mantra, by chanting the mantra, when the Karpura Aarti, the camphor Aarti is shown, it symbolizes that the light which is known as sadhana, by which we can be enlightened about our own nature. So temple worship, that too saguna upasana, the worship which is leads to form worship. Every form has got a tattva. Tattva means they have their own message, they have their own methodology. For example, there is Narayana, always he is in the standing posture. And sometimes like a Ranganatha, he is in the Yoga Nidra. It symbolizes the snake coiled bed, also symbolizes samsara. So also he is in the Kshira Sagara. Kshira Sagara means milky ocean. So all these meanings, they are connected with the philosophy, the secret of our life. Therefore, here he says that everything is connected to me. For example, in the seventh chapter, also we will come to know in elaborate way. So I can summarize a little bit here. We have the three levels of understanding about Ishvara. So when you want to understand about the God, you should have God is the concept. So when the God is almighty, our mind doesn't have the capacity to see, to communicate. When people say that you do namaskara in front of God, so if God is kept in front of you, it becomes very easy to get namaskara done. But if I say that God is everywhere, you do namaskara, will you do namaskara all the side? You will get confused. Therefore, a form is given. That form too, we have got aneka rupa bhakti. Aneka rupa bhakti means, so many varieties of forms are given. All the forms, they have their own speciality. Like Lord Ganesha, he has got his own speciality. Lord Garuda, he has got his own speciality. And Maheshwara, Mahavishnu, and Rama, Krishna, so this Vamana, so many varieties of forms we have. All the forms, Saguna Brahma Upasana, that is the first stage of bhakti. So when you want to focus in your mind, you need to have a form. Therefore, that form is given as a Saguna Upasana, so you can develop your capacity to focus in a place. Then you will get connected with the philosophy, the tattva, the secret of those mantras. See, every deity also endowed with mantra. So then you can focus on the mantra, it becomes a little bit more subtle. So first your mind is engaged with the form, whether it is Dakshinamurti or Narayana or Mahavishnu or Vasudeva, so whatever the name is given, those deities have their own mantra. Then you will, after a certain period of time, you will get connected with mantra. So when you get connected with the mantra, you are connected with the world, that secret power of the world. Then after few years, you will realize that every form which is connected by the consciousness of Ishvara, now you can see one God in all other God, then you will become what? So, Ekarupa Bhakti. So first, Ekarupa Bhakti and Anekarupa Bhakti means in all deities you will see one God, and mentally you can transcendent the form. That is what, you know, once you become a Rama Bhakta, so you worship, keep on worship Ram, Lord Ram. After that, whatever the temple you go, you only see the Ram. First you say that Ram is only one God. Krishna is the only one God. So Lord Shiva is the only one God. For me, in Mumbai, so Ganapati is the only one God. They don't worship any other deity, nothing wrong in that. You could say, we could have seen that Shiva Purana talks only about Lord Shiva. So it doesn't give priority for Lord Vishnu. Vishnu Purana, it talks about only Lord Vishnu. Doesn't give importance for Shiva. So even doesn't talk about other deities. It is focused. Nothing wrong. That is how it has to be like that. Because then alone you will be focused. So once you are matured enough, focused enough, then you can just feel and understand other God also the same God. Therefore, first when you say Rama is the only God, I'm not going to go other temple. Therefore, Rama temple is in everywhere. Lord Mahavishnu temple is everywhere. You can go. So after certain period of time, when you become matured, so you will understand definitely Rama exists in all other deity, in all other temple. Whatever the temple you go, whichever the object means the deity in front of you, you could see Rama in that. You become Anekarupa Bhakti. Then it goes up to Arupa Bhakti, which is known as Nirguna Upasana. So first Ekarupa Bhakti, then Anekarupa Bhakti, then Arupa Bhakti. Then finally what? The Bhakti remains, all the form goes. That is the secret of our Upasana methodology. This verse is the indication of that philosophy which is going to be revealed later on when the matter comes about Ishvara. The God concept very nicely and in useful way and spectacularly established in all the way it is possible. Even people round the tree. So today morning I heard from one of my students' relative. They were suffering without the progeny. They were not having children. And medically everything they tried a lot, and medical people say that they don't have any problem. So physically they don't have any problem. So psychologically also they don't have any problem, but the children is not taking place. Then somebody said, you know, you go and you round the neem tree, which is endowed with Ashwatha tree. So this both tree, wherever it exists, it has got its own science. So now we are looking everything as a scientific perception. A carpenter suggested them to go and round the tree where this neem and the Ashwatha trees are together. They started doing for 48 days, and after 48 days they got the opportunity, they got pregnancy, well, now they have their own baby. So it's, I was thinking a lot, every form that I am, whatever the way, as a tree, even Lord Vinayaka can be invoked in Haldi, in the stone, in the mud. So that our system is very simple. Therefore, people who doesn't believe God, the concept has to be understood at all. So we have a duty to teach to the next generation what the concept of God is. So the concept of God can be invoked anywhere, everywhere, even Atmanam. So considering myself as the deity, so I can do puja to myself. That is also possible. Deho devalaya prokto jivo deva sanatanaha tejer ajnana nirmalyam soham bhavena pujayet. Every puja you make yourself as the deity, it is possible, it is acceptable, nothing wrong in that. Therefore, this worship is the boon, the methodology which are given as the boon. You don't see ritual as a mere ritual. So rituals are valuable tool in our life, the great invention. Just we have to analyze, understand, we have to get it done, lots of research. So we can't get it done. But every ritual, whether it is with mantra, without mantra, only showing the comfort, arati, it's enough. You are communicating. You can communicate. You need not to have a special initiation for that. Just keep a stone and put the bindi and start seeing, pursuing the Lord in that. Do naivedya. Matter is over. The worship is done. That's what Krishna is very clearly saying that. So whatever the way people worship, they are worshipping me, they will reach me. Nothing wrong in that. And now the question arises, so why do people want to have difference of varieties of worship? Because they are fond of varieties of karma phala. Kankshantah karmanam siddhim yajantaiha devatah kshipram himanushe loke siddhir bhavati karmaja. This earth is known as a karma bhumi, where you can get whatever you wish. The first understanding to be given to all young generation, all the children, that you, whatever you wish, you will get it. But it depends on the density, how you wish, how you will to wish. So that is, that does matter. So when you wish, when you bring into the action, definitely you will get. That is the glory of the earth. In Swarga Loka, you cannot earn. In Patala Loka, you cannot earn, because you don't have the body, the specialized body, like the human being. The human being is very precious because they have the eligibility called Kartumva Akartumva Niyatava Kartum Shakyam. Therefore, we have to be thankful to the Almighty. This body which is given as the boat, you can get it done, a ritual. Those, every ritual is me jaan hai. Please try to understand, any ritual you follow, that ritual with complete dedication, you will get whatever you want, but you have to be careful what you want. And you have to be focused, you have to keep digging, 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 means you have to keep making effort. Therefore, this world, this universe is called Karma Bhumi. There, whatever you wish, you will get it. Usually, people also wish for so many things. As we saw in the first chapter itself, there are four kinds of goals are taken by human being. First, for security. We wish to have the security, automatically we gain that longing to get the security. Whether it is animal or human being, any creature in this world, when it is born with insecurity. So many secrets behind, maybe, But here we are born with an insecurity. Now the effort comes to become secure. For we use our will, I have to be secure. For security, I have to make my efforts. That's the first understanding. The security, as I have given the great example, newly born baby, when it was taken from his mom, it cries. The first effort, that effort continues to get the security. So I have to be secure. I have to be secure. So if I am 5 years old, I should be secure enough. 10 years old, I should be secure enough. So 30 years old, I have to be secure enough. So this security, we seek security. Therefore what? We seek karma phala. We all of us are called a desirer of the result. Kankshantaha karmanam siddhi. Everybody is a desirer of karma phala. We use our worship to gain it. We expect, we work, we make effort in order to get what we want. The first thing is security. Once we become secure, we want to gain the happiness. This is the second level of effort. So I want to be happy. I want to be happy. I want to be happy. Not only me, my family has to be happy. If my family is all happy, then I will be happy. So my people, when they are happy, I am also happy. So that happiness lies on others' happiness. Now I have to hunt happiness. So hunting for security, hunting for happiness, it becomes the life. So these two efforts are made even by the animals. Isn't it? Every animal wants to be secure, wants to be happiness. But they don't have bank balance, they don't have insurance, they don't have any job. So because job also gives security. They don't have any power, they don't have any constitutions, but they are happy, they are secure. And do you know that any bird, when it dies, it doesn't come in front of us. Only the human being, when we are dying, when we are achieving death, we want to be among all the people. Because even while achieving death, we are not succeed enough to become away from the insecurity. Now what kind of life we have to live? We have to analyze. We are desirer of security. So how can we gain it? So we are desirer of pleasure. How can we achieve it? Now the puja, the rituals. So all the pujas or rituals are followed to get something, to achieve something. Artho arthate jignyasu jnani cha bharata rushabha. Krishna himself is going to introduce. There are four kinds of devotees. The people, when they worship, when they have in danger situation, they worship. So other varieties of people, if they want to have something, they worship. Otherwise, they don't worship. And the next category of people, you know, for the knowledge, seeking the knowledge, they worship. The final varieties of people with the knowledge, with Atmajnana, they worship. So these words to accept, yes, I am karma phala akankshi. So I am the desire of karma phala. Okay, once you are the desirer of karma phala, so you worship. Iha devataha, we worship in different manner. We worship the company, the brand of the company. So you may not have the devotion towards Lord Parameshwara or Maheshwara or Mahavishnu, but you may have the fond of your brand. So your company brand. So you worship your company brand, that is also considered as the worship alone. You may not chant the mantras, you may not do all the aratis, you may not offering the food, but you are worshipping as the brand is your God. When you love your family members, when you love your relatives, you are working for them, you are earning money for them, you are spending a whole lifetime to earn money, to protect them, you are worshipping them. That effort, because we love to gain the happiness. They are working for happiness. And third level is dharma. Dharma means what? Patanjali Yoga Sutra says, when you gain the capacity, little bit matured enough, you become away from animality. That animalness, I don't know whether the word are there or not, animalness, the tendency to be an animal. So animal only expects to be secure, to be happy, but we think that everybody has to be happy, everybody has to be secure, all people should be happy. For that we have to seek dharma, that's all. Nobody wants to have moksha, so moksha is not attained by karma. Therefore nobody wants to pursue moksha, that's what he says. So the previous verses, they spoke about the people who wants to have moksha. Vitaraga bhaya krodaha. So that shloka says, manmaya mamu pashritaha. Then finally, puta madbhava magataha. So they identify themselves with my consciousness. Means they are making effort for liberation. No animal is making effort for the liberation. Human being alone should make for the liberation. Why all people are not making effort for liberation? The answer is given, because they are karma phala kankshinaha. They are desirer of fruit, the result of action. But they get whatever they wish. Kshipram hi manushe loke. So immediately, no time, they will gain whatever they wish. Siddhir bhavati karmaja. The earth itself is like that. The environment, which is known as earth, universe, is endowed with karma phala. It's not surprise to see all the people, because the earth is like that. Many people are fond of karma phala. Therefore, they are not looking moksha. They are not attracted by moksha. Moksha is not attracted to them. Therefore, I have created different method for them. I only create Chaturvarnya, the system of Chaturvarnya. And in this verse, the next verse, lots of people only understand of, other of is not understood. When Lord says, I am the Karta of Chaturvarnya, they will hold it. Now Bhagavan Krishna create all this difference, the difference among the people, though human being we are the same, but Lord Krishna wants to divide into four category, and there is no superiority, inferiority. Wait, Lord himself, he has told, Vidhi akartaram avyayam. Avyayam akartaram iti vidhi. I am the author, I am the doer, I am the karta, but I am akarta too. That portion is not understood. If you want to understand, if you want to have the debate on these words, or based on this concept, this verse, you should just understand what the meaning is interpreted by the learned people, by the people of lineage. Otherwise, you don't have the rights. Bhagavan says that I am a karta. I am the karta. I am a karta too. So what does it mean? What does it mean? How can we understand the concept? Therefore, we have to be with lineage people. That's what here is given. Let us read the verse. This verse is very important. I have spoken about this verse long back. So now we are into the same verse. Just we'll read it. Chatur varnyam maya srittam guna karma vibhagashah tasya kartaram api bham vidya kartaram avyayam. Very simple. The statement, this all Chaturvarna is created by me. And it is created on the base of gunas and karmas. Guna vibhagaha and karma vibhagaha. I am the creator of these four Chaturvarna. And I am not the creator even. These both statements to be realized very well. We will understand properly, because these words is being debated by long time by the people, not understanding what Krishna wants to say. Just we will understand the Almighty's message. It's very good and boon for the society. Not even for the society, boon for every individual. Not to create any superiority, inferiority complex. The human beings are even. Even all the creatures are even. There is no dead material. There is no that consciousness, conscious material, unconscious material. So no jada, no chetana. Everything is nothing but Brahman. That is the message of Upanishad and Bhagavad Gita. But here it talks about the process through which I can improve myself. That process has got its own norms. That norms are given in this verse. We will understand in the next session tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.